Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to discuss all of the palettes that I used no palette behind in 2022. As you might know, one of my goals last year was to use every single eyeshadow in my collection. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to, but I did use quite a few palettes no palette left behind, which if you're new to that concept means they use every single shade in that palette. So today I'm going to talk through the palettes that I managed to use no palette left behind, and yeah, just go over them and let you know my thoughts. But before I jump into that, if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you in the family. Let's jump into the video. So the first palette I have to talk about is quite an obvious one. By the way, these are organized by brand, not by kind of which order I used them. No palette left behind, if that makes sense. So the first palette, like I said, is a no-brainer, and that is my Modern Renaissance palette. This is my, or this was my 2022 Panda palette. I'm still working on finishing this. I have 3 shades left. I'm not going to show you the inside because I am still going to update this at my Panda palette updates. But this is one that I obviously used no palette left behind. I used a lot. I mean, I used up, I can give you a little sneak peek. I used up a lot of the palettes. So yeah, I mean, again, this was an obvious one to be in this video. I'm not going to talk about it too much because I haven't mentioned this palette so much in the last year, as obviously since I've been working on it, but that is the first palette. Continuing on with Anastasia, the next palette that I used no palette behind is my Soft Glam palette. This one is a beautiful neutral palette and I really, really loved working on this. This is another one that this is the first palette, I think, that I've reached no palette behind in 2022. In 2023 as well. I already used this no palette behind this year. I really like this palette. Like I said, it is quite an old palette in my collection. I got this in 2018, I believe. So yeah, it is definitely aged a little bit, but it still works fine. And until some of the shimmers might not be as impactful as I remember, but also that might just be because I've now found better things, like for example the shadow that I'm wearing on my lips today, which is super sparkly, super special. And these more kind of satiny shimmers might just seem more satiny than they used to, just because I found better things. So yeah, this is a palette that I'm definitely going to try to get more use out of this year. I already rolled a shade of this into my Panos eyeshadows, and I'm hoping to roll more shades of this in, because I do really want to work on this palette and just show you some more love, because it doesn't look nearly enough loved as I would have hoped after 5 years in my collection, or almost 5 years in my collection. Another palette from Anastasia, which is probably one of my favorite Anastasia palettes, is the Norvina palette. I love this one. I used this no palette left behind last year because it was in my product level up palette. I used this palette there and I really like the way this palette looks now. I can tell, like, obviously I have a couple pans, but even the eyeshadows that I don't have pan in, they do have some dips, like these shadows here, mainly the shimmers to be honest, but that's kind of what I want my palettes to look like. I don't want there to just be pans and then no dips at all. So I like the way this one looks, and yeah, I really love this palette. Like I said, I think you can tell the way it looks. This was definitely newer in my collection compared to the other Anastasia palettes I just mentioned. I can't remember when I picked this one up though, but again, it is newer and I really love this palette. The shimmers in here are more impactful. They're definitely more sparkly, more kind of thick and metallic than the ones in the Soft Glam palette. So yeah, I love this palette and again, I want to use this more this year. We also have my Sultry palette, again from Anastasia. I used to think all of my Anastasia palettes, no palette behind apart from the Jackie Aina palette. So that might be a spoiler of what's coming up, but this is what the Sultry palette looks like. Again, I used this no palette behind. I wish this one looked a little bit more loved. This is kind of what I mean, like I have some pans in here, but the rest of the shades look almost untouched. I feel like this shade maybe looks a little touched. But you know, overall, I feel like I want to use this more. I want to use it more organically, not just to pan. But yeah, I do like this palette, and a lot of people have panned this palette recently. And I would potentially consider panning this one as well. I think I would pan the Soft Glam palette before this one though, both because of age and also because, I don't know, I feel like I'm more keen to pan that one because it's more kind of everyday for me. This one is a bit more smoky. But yeah, this one again, I like the formula better off than the Soft Glam, because I mean, I don't dislike the Soft Glam at all. It might come across that way, but I think like a handful of the shades in there, like Glistening and Fairy, are the two that I can think of on the top of my head. They are very satiny, but you know, shades like bronze and sultry. They're very kind of sparkly, and you know, they're still really nice shimmers. So I'm not saying the whole palette is bad or anything, but this one definitely, I prefer the shimmer formula in this one than I do in Soft Glam, for example. Next up we have my Subculture palette. This one looks like this. It has a lot of pans. I have this is actually, I think, one of my newest Anastasia palettes, but you can see that I have a lot of love in here. I have pans on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 shadows, more than half the palette. I love this palette. It was definitely a divider when it came out. Actually, sorry, I have 9 pans. This one here, Adorn, is very rusty, so you can't tell the pans. So it's 9 pans, actually. But again, this one was a divider when it came out. I like it. I got mine quite late. I got mine in 2021, end of 2021, so 2 years ago. So again, not the newest palette in my collection, but it's relatively new. And maybe since I got a later edition of the Subculture palette, I didn't have those issues that it first had when it came out. Obviously, it is quite crumbly. A lot of the Anastasia palettes are crumbly, like that is the formula of them. This one is probably the most extreme one, but it's nowhere near as crumbly as some people, you know, talked about when it first came out. But yeah, I like this palette. It's more of a kind of muted, grungy, kind of colourful palette, but it's definitely unique in my collection and I love having this around. Then last up for Anastasia palettes, we have my Amrissi palette. This is one that I think is one of the latest ones that I used No Pan Left Behind, because I used this here and there in the year, but then towards the end of the year I kind of tried to narrow down and look at the palettes that I had used maybe half the shades, and I tried to finish up using the rest of them. And this is one of those. This is another one palette that I wish I had shown more love in the past year. Again, I have a couple pans in here, but the rest of the shades almost look untouched. It has one of my favorite shades from our mainstream palette, which is Barb, which is this shade here. And I love this color story. It actually does remind me a little bit of Novena, with the purple and pinks together with the kind of more warm tones. But yeah, this one is obviously a bigger palette, and it's not my absolute favorite Anastasia palette, but it is up there. I really like it. I would have potentially made some changes to it if I could. But overall, I'm happy to have this in my collection, and again, it is one of my newer Anastasia palettes, not my newest by any means, but it's not as old as, for example, Modern Renaissance, obviously, Soft Glam, and Norvina. Moving into Colourpop next, the first palette we have is Lilac You A Lot. This is what this one looks like. I use this as kind of like whenever I needed a purple, I reached for this palette because I knew I could find purples in here. I like this palette. I much prefer this palette to the It's My Pleasure palette, which is the other purple palette. That one has been decluttered and put into my singles collection, but I do like this palette. It's my kind of purple palette of choice. I am keeping this as it is for now. Most of my Colourpop palettes I have dismantled into singles, but this one I do like enough to keep around as it is. So yeah, that is the first Colourpop palette that I use No Pan Left Behind. Next up we have my Going Coconuts palette. Again, this is one that I use No Pan Left Behind. I also hit one pan last year, which is this shade here. I used that organically, used to hit pan on it, and I did. Again, I wish I could have shown more love to this palette last year. I do really like this. It's a nice neutral palette with kind of a unique undertone. But a lot of my neutral palettes got a bit neglected last year because I was panning Modern Renaissance, and that is more of a neutral palette. I mean, some people might say it's quite colourful with like Realgar and Venetian Red and Love Letter and those shades, but to me those are neutral shades. They're like slightly colourful neutral shades, but they're still neutral shades. They're not very colourful. Like what I'm wearing today in my eyes, that's colourful to me. But yeah, this palette, I'm again going to try to use more this year. The palette I'm panning this year, which actually most of the shades that I'm wearing on my eyes today, actually all the mattes that I'm wearing on my eyes today are from a Panna palette. So it's more colourful, so hopefully I can get some more use out of my neutral palettes this year. But again, I used this No Pan Left Behind at least, so that's good, but I wish I would have used, you know, every shade more than once. Another palette that I kind of used towards the end of the year just to pick out the shades that I had not yet used was the Aha Honey palette. Mine looks slightly different because I have taken out Belusa and put it in a different shade, but this is what mine looks like. I like this palette again. It is my yellow palette of choice. Similarly to the Lilac You A Lot palette, I have decided to keep this as it is, mainly because when I, or if I would were to depot this, I'm not sure what shades I would get rid of. I like most of the shades in here. So yeah, I'm keeping it as it is for now, and I think this palette is quite handy to have. It's definitely not one that I would reach for every single day, but I do love a yellow eye look, especially in summer, so I'm gonna try to remember to reach for this one then. Last year I didn't reach for this one until like autumn and winter even, so I'm gonna try to reach for this one more in summer because that is when I prefer the yellow tones. Next up for the £9 palette from Colourpop, we have my MAR palette, and I mention this all the time, but this one looks quite different from the original MAR because mine is a big mishmash of the MAR, the Soul, and a couple other shades. This was my Product Level Up palette again. I might have had some of the other palettes that I mentioned as my Product Level Up, but I forgot. Yeah, this palette I definitely used that way. So I hit a couple pans, I hit 2 pans I believe, and I used every single shade twice. So again, it's another palette that I reached no pan left behind. Then lastly for Colourpop, we have my favorite Colourpop palette, and that is the Star Wars Mandalorian The Child palette. I just love the tones in here. I have talked about this palette so much. The greens are beautiful, they work really well with neutrals. I can create like grungy green looks. And yeah, I just love this. The shimmers in here are absolutely stunning as well. I have quite a few pans. I have 4 pans. And yeah, this palette looks quite loved. I wish I could get some more use out of these top shades there, because I feel like they don't really have any dips or anything. But overall, I'm really happy with how this palette is looking. And I'm also happy that how it looks reflects kind of how I feel about it, and you know, I do really love this, like I said. Next up, I'm gonna breeze over 2 palettes because they're both decluttered from my collection. We have my 2 Juvia's Place palettes. The first one is the Magic Mini palette, and this one is still intact. I used every single shade in here last year. I have a lot of pans. It hurts me, it pains me a little bit to let go of this palette because I have so many pans, and it's really gonna put down my pan percentage, but can't hold on to palettes just because I have pans in them. And it's time to let this one go, it's no longer my favorite. And then similarly, another palette that is no longer my favorite, and I decided to declutter and depot shades. So this one looks very different because I have taken out 4 of the shadows, actually 5 of the shadows, but I have quite a lot left in here. This palette is the Tri palette, and again, it looks very different, but this one has been decluttered. But I did use this one, no pan left behind, like I said last year as well. So we're gonna move into more kind of high-end palette next, or like my more kind of fancy palettes, I guess. And the first one is my Natasha Denona Metropolis palette. I love this palette, it's a very beautiful palette. This was my first Natasha Denona palette, and this is what mine looks like. I wish I, again, had more dips in this palette because it is such a stunning one. But I'm gonna try to use this one more this year. I just love this palette. I love the layout. I wish you came up with more palettes in this layout. I love the colors in here. Like, you have those grungy greens again, which I really like. You have some warm tones if you want to have pop colors. I think a lot of people can look at this palette and feel very overwhelmed just with the layout, but for me it's just very inspiring. I think it's, yeah, it's a stunning palette, and the formula in here is amazing. It's not my top favorite, formula from Natasha Denona, but it's still really, really good. And again, the color story is just absolutely amazing, and that is the first palette. Next up is my actual favorite palette from Natasha Denona, and that is the gold palette. You all know this. I love this palette, and this is what mine looks like. This one looks quite used. I have dips in a lot of the shades, and no pans because I haven't dared to roll anything into like projects. I did use this shade here, and I think these 2 shades I had in different projects, but I only used them 15 times, but you can see the dips in them. I love this palette. I love the formula. I love the color story. I love how kind of curated the color story is. I love that you have some more cool tones here. You have really bright gold shades to have those pops of blues, which work really well with the golds. And yeah, I think this is an amazing palette. I always say I'm not sure if this is discontinued. I think it was discontinued and then came back, but I'm not sure the status now. But if it is, it's such a shame because it's an amazing palette, and it's definitely one of my favorites in my whole collection, and it was a joy to use last year. The next palette I have is the Sunrise palette, which is a midi palette, and this one looks like this. Again, I used this one no pan left behind. This is a very interesting color story. I think this one was very unique when it came out. I think a lot of people, a lot of color stories now has been trying to dupe this kind of color story out, but I think it's stunning. It's so saturated with like these kind of mattes especially, and then you have some duochrome shimmers, you have these kind of lighter shades here if you want to do something lighter, but again, you can do some really saturated looks, you can create some really beautiful sunset looks. And yeah, I used to love this palette. It's not, again, my favorite formula from Natasha Denona. I feel like, you know, for example, this one is not as good as the Metropolis either. It's probably one of my least favorite formulas from her, but the color story is just absolutely stunning, and I love this palette. Then my probably least favorite palette from Natasha Denona is the Love palette. For some reason, I just don't reach for this palette very much. I do have one pan in here now, which I hit last year. But I just didn't reach for this palette at all. But towards the end of the year, I made myself reach for this one. But I reached for it mainly as an accent palette. I used it together with a lot of other palettes. But in general, to be fair, that's how I do my makeup a lot of the time, because I am panning so many eyeshadows in different palettes. I don't really reach for one singular palette very often to create a look. You should pick and choose from different palettes. But anyway, this palette, again, is not my favorite. It is beautiful. I really wanted this for a really long time, but I don't reach for it nearly as much as I wanted to. However, I did reach for every single shade last year, which is good. But yeah, again, I want to play around with this palette more this year and get to know it better, because I feel like I don't really know what to do with this palette, and that's why I don't like it as much. But yeah, that is the next palette from Natasha Denona. Then next up, we have my newest Natasha Denona palette, and that is the bronze palette. I actually got this for my birthday in November, so I only had this for the last month and a half of the year. But I used every single shade in here. I absolutely love this palette, and it still looks pretty brand new because I only used it a couple times. I definitely used a couple shades more than once, but overall I only reached for this like a very few times. I love this palette though. Every single look that I created with this palette, I fell in love with. It's very sexy, very smoky, but you can also create like more light looks, and the tones in here are just very kind of warm and cozy. And yeah, this is the one that I'm so excited to play around with more this year. I'm excited to have this for summer and for autumn, because I got this again, my birthday is 19th of November, so I got this late November, and I think this is more of a summer kind of into autumn palette. I think this is going to be so beautiful in summer with a tan, and just create some really beautiful smoky bronze looks. So yeah, I'm excited to have this palette, and I love it very much. Then lastly, for Natasha Denona is a palette that I always forget about because it's so small. This is my mini retro palette. I love this palette too. I used this again, No Pan Left Behind. It was quite easy. It's only 5 shades, but it's one that I want to play around with more. I want to create a look just using this palette, because again, when I used this last year, I used like 1 or 2 shades in each look, and I want to create one using all of the shades. So that's something that I'm going to do this year. Again, this is a palette that I picked up last year, so it's relatively new to my collection, but I do want to show it some more love this year. Next up, we have 3 palettes that all look the same, and they are my Pat McGrath palettes. I'm going to start with my oldest one, which is my Utopian Dream. I love this palette. It's beautiful. I've had this now for just over a year. I got this for my birthday last year, actually. So yeah, just over a year. And I love this palette. It's so beautiful, and I can't wait to reach for this one more this spring, because it's such a beautiful spring tone palette. The special shades in here are absolutely stunning, and yeah, I'm not going to talk about these too much because I mention these all the time, but I'm happy that I managed to reach for all 3 actually of these No Pan Left Behind style. Then the second one is both of the next ones actually I got again beginning of November. I got it from one of her sales that she had end of October, but I did receive it into my collection end of November, I believe. Or it was, I got it in November anyway. But this is the next palette, which is the Bronze Seduction palette. This is one that I wanted for a long, long time. I reach for Tant all the time, so obviously I reach for it, No Pan Left Behind. But again, I'm excited to play around with this more this year because it is so new to my collection. Then the last one is the Divine Rose one, which is probably not my least favorite, but it's the least exciting color story, I guess, for me. But it's one that I think is going to be really nice for everyday looks. And again, I'm really excited to play around with this more. This is actually quite a nice wintry palette, so I might reach for this one very soon. It's nice to do this video because it reminds me that I want to reach for these palettes. But yeah, I love this palette too, but I just, again, haven't played around with it that much. So I'm excited to do that this year. And with that, I'm actually really excited because I used all of my Natasha Denona and all of my Pat McGrath palettes, No Pan Left Behind, last year, which is really good because they are the most expensive palettes in my collection. So I'm excited that I was able to show them some love. So we're on to my last pile of palettes, and the next brand we're going to talk about is Huda Beauty. The first one is my Mercury Retrograde palette, this one looks like this. This is a palette that I have used quite a bit, and you know, it's not my favorite palette. I mentioned this before, it's probably my least favorite Huda Beauty palette. Maybe the Gold Obsessions is down there too, but this one is just not my favorite. I know a lot of people adore this palette, and I can see why. But yeah, just these colors, I don't know, there's just something about it that I'm not super inspired by, although it is a very inspiring color story. I want to play around with more. Again, it's a very springtone palette, so I'm excited to play around with it this year as well. I'm excited to get some more use out of this palette overall this year, because obviously I have some pans in this palette, especially in the shimmers. I think those are the only shades that I have pan in. I only have two pans in here. I'm hoping to get some more dips, and like for example the mineral, I want to show some more love there, because again with this palette it looks very untouched apart from the pans, so I want to show the palette like some more overall love this year, just to make it look a bit more loved and not dug into. Then we have the Rose Quartz palette, which is my newest Huda Beauty palette, and I love this palette. This is such a stunning one. I've had this for about a year now, and again it's one that I'm so excited to reach for more this year as well. I reached for this quite a bit last year, and it was no issue at all reaching for this one, no pan left behind, because I fell in love with this palette last year. It's so beautiful, it's so, like, the color story is very unique, the tones in here are very unique to my collection. I don't have too many cool tone palettes. I did pick up a few more like in the last year or two, but yeah, this is probably my favorite cool tone palette. It probably even beats the Divine Rose one from Pat McGrath, at least so far. I haven't played around with that one too much, but this one is just so stunning. It's unbeatable. I love this palette so much. Then we have the two smaller Huda Beauty palettes in my collection. The first one is the Nude Obsessions. This one looks like this. I love the color story, it's so curated. I love the romantic tones. Like, these type of tones in my collection, I love. I love them on me. I love just looking at them. They just make me happy. Like, these type of pinky, peachy tones. And again, it's one I want to show more love this year, but it is looking quite well used, but I want to get some more use out of this overall this year, and I really do like this palette. Then lastly for Huda Beauty, we have the Gold Obsessions palette. This is again one that is like, I look in it now and I think it's beautiful, but I put this as like one of my least favorite Huda Beauty palettes, mainly because it's so overlapping with the color story in my collection, but I love it. I'm just looking at it now and I love this color story. Again, this looks quite loved. It has quite a few dips, especially in the shimmers, so I'm happy with that. I wish, again, obviously all my palettes looked a bit more well-loved, but I'm happy with how this one looks now, and I'm happy that I was able to use the no palette behind last year. So we have four more palettes to go. The first one is my Wilderness palette from Beauty Bay. This is one that was my Product Level Up palette again, and this one looks like this. I was able to obviously use this with no palette behind because of that, and I also hit quite a few pans. This was my level 5 palette, so I hit 5 pans in here, and it looks quite loved now, this palette. The Beauty Bay shimmer formula is quite easy to pan on, and that's kind of the ones that I chose to pan on. Obviously the like cream shade I also pan on, but yeah, I love this palette. It's quite a unique color story. It's almost like a rainbow palette, but not quite. And I do like this palette quite a bit. Yeah, it's not my most favorite color story. Maybe it's because I don't reach for these tones every single day. They're quite a bit I don't know, brighter. Like, I love creating bright looks, but you know, it's not maybe my favorite. Like, I know for example, like these more kind of greeny, these more kind of bluey greens are not always my favorite. I do love these type of greens, and like these colors here, I love though. So, you know, there's part of this palette that I absolutely adore. There's part that I might not use very often, but I was happy that I was able to use this so much last year, especially as my product level up level 5 palette, because it meant that I can really play around with the palette. And overall, I do really love it, but it's not my favorite palette in my collection. I actually realized that I was missing one palette, so there's now 4 palettes left. The next one is my Club Enebria palette from Kaleidos. This one looks like this. Again, this one looks a bit more loved now. I love this palette. It's such a unique color story. I think it's such a well-made palette, and it's again very unique to my collection. It has a lot of deeper tones. It has a lot of unique kind of shades of, like, the colors in here are very unique. I love everything about this palette. I love the packaging. It feels very sturdy. I love the artwork on it, and the shimmers in here are stunning. They're duochromes. They're very sparkly, and yeah, this palette is so good. It's such a shame that it's discontinued, but I'm happy that I was able to show some love to this last year, and I'm showing some more love to this year. I'm actually working on this as my product level up level 1 palette this year, so I'm already showing this some love, and there should be no pan left behind very soon. I have one shade left to work on in here, and then it's going to be no pan left behind for this year too. So yeah, I'm very excited this is getting some love, and I'm definitely going to continue reaching for this one this year. Then we have my Blueberry Muffin palette, another one that was my product level up palette. And this one looks like this. It's very, very well loved, mainly because it's my Doodoo Palma Bellowship palette. not last year but the year before, with my friend Martina. And yeah, I like this palette. It's not my favorite. This was one that was on the shopping block for me last year, but I do like it and it's very unique to my collection. I don't have a lot of blues in my palette, so I'm happy to have this one. And honestly, like, the formula in here is impeccable. Like, it's so good. And I also love these kind of brown tones with the blues. They work so well together. And yeah, it's a really well-made palette. I think the reason why it was on my shopping block was because I was so worn down on it after the Juju Palma Bellaship project. But yeah, that is the next one, and I'm happy to have this one in my collection too. We have two more palettes to go. The next one is my Odin's Eye Red Dragon palette, which was a collaboration with Judy. This one looks like this. It's a very me color story, but I don't reach for this palette enough. And this is another one that I really want to focus in on to use more this year, because I love every single tone in here. I love every single eyeshadow, but I just don't reach for it nearly as much as I should. So I'm gonna try again to show this some more love this year, because it looks almost brand new. Then the last palette, which is actually the last palette as well on the list, which is the one I forgot about, is the Tiny Mauves palette from Sydney Grace, because this is the last palette that I hit no pan left behind this past year, because it was my product level up palette for the final palette of the year. This one looks like this. It definitely looks more well loved now. He has a few dips and stuff, and I'm really, really happy with that. I'm gonna again try to use this more this year, because it's such a good palette. The quality is so good, the color story is amazing, and yeah, I just love this. Again, it has a lot of kind of muted tones, which I just love. I love wearing, and it's kind of when I want to wear colorful on the everyday, I reach for these kind of tones. So I'm not gonna ramble on about this palette too much, because I talked about it a lot in my product level up palette at the end of the year, but I'm really happy that I rolled this one in that project, and I was able to use this no pan left behind. And that is the final palette that I have to talk about. And in total last year I reached for 33 palettes non-pan left behind style, which is so good. It's quite a lot. I mean, obviously I wanted to reach for every single palette no pan left behind style, but again, that was 33. And out of all my palettes, at the end of last year, before my declutter and everything, I had 44 palettes. So that is really good. Let me calculate quickly how many percentage that is, what percentage that is. That is 75% of my palettes, which is again very good. And this year I'm hoping to do every single palette no pan left behind style. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and looking into my collection a bit more and seeing which palette I actually used all the way last year. But I hope you're having a lovely day wherever you are, and I'll catch you in my next one. Bye guys!